Hello, hello, and hello! Do you know what STEM stands for? The fields of science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. Today, we are going to talk about some innovative women who stand out specifically in science. But to introduce these groundbreaking professionals, I've brought in a special guest from the Nexans team. Welcome, Sylvie!
Thanks, Frédéric. It's great to be here. And I got some cool things to share. But before we get started,
don't forget to like and subscribe below.
When we think of great scientists, the name that often comes to mind is Marie Curie. She was the first woman to win the Nobel Prize and remains as the only person to win two Nobel Prizes in distinct scientific fields, physics and chemistry, in 1903 and 1911, respectively. Although Marie Curie is the most well-known, she's not the only woman to make an impact in science. Let's take a look at three other talented, inspiring women who made contributions in the fields of grid engineering, nuclear physics, and electrical appliances. Let's start with Edith Clark, electrical engineer and mathematician. Remarkable for her contribution to distribution networks and transmission grids. During World War I, Edith worked for the Transmission and Protection Engineering Department, leading a group of female computers, that is, those who compute. She was a pioneer in electrical engineering, especially with the development of mathematical methods. Methods she developed to simplify how engineers characterized larger power lines. This was achieved by a specific invention of hers, the Clark calculator, which made a system of calculation allowing analysts to solve key equations 10 times faster than before. What Edith did was incorporate voltage, current relation, and hyperbolic function into her graphical calculator. Engineers were able to better determine the stability of transmission lines, and so high voltage systems with longer distances and heavier loads became more efficient. But that's not all. Edith also invented a mathematical method known as the method of symmetrical components, which models a power system and its behavior during faults and short circuits. Today, every engineer is aware of this method, and it is taught around schools worldwide. It is safe to say that Edith Clark paved the way for future engineers, that her achievements provided inspiration and set precedent for the next generation. It is no secret why she was inducted to the US National Inventors Hall of Fame. When noting honorables in electricity, one name that cannot be missed is Lise Mner, an Austrian-born scientist who made groundbreaking discoveries regarding nuclear physics. Sadly, Lise is one of many whose work was not fully recognized. Much of her achievements were accredited to her male colleagues. From the start, nothing came easy for Lise, not even her education. Despite the support of highly educated parents, Lise's academics were made more difficult because of the regulations of her times. Austria's universities began accepting women only after 1897, and to be admitted, female candidates had to pass a demanding exam. They were required to undergo 2 years of prep in a small class of women. Why? Because high schools were not open to women at this time either. But that didn't stop Lise. She went on to receive her doctorate in 1905 with the highest possible distinctions, and in doing so, developed a passion for physics. In 1907, Lise moved to Germany to study with Max Planck, a renowned physicist in his own right. And guess what? She needed special permission from the universities to do so. Cut to 1912, Lise has joined Otto Hahn in Berlin. But the director of the institute where Hahn worked was reluctant to let women on the premises. So Lise and Otto began their research in the basement laboratory. This was the start of their 30-year collaboration. And early on, in 1917, they discovered a new chemical element, protactinium. In 1923, Lise discovered the phenomenon of electron emission from excited atoms, which later became known as the Auger effect. named after the French scientist who completed an analysis that Lise initiated. Finally, Lise was the first to understand a process that would come to be known as nuclear fission, a phenomenon where a heavy atomic nucleus is split into two or more lighter nuclides. This nuclear reaction is accompanied by neutron emissions and a very significant release of energy, much more significant than any chemical reaction. Such emissions led to chain reactions, and this discovery was later implemented in power plants for nuclear generation. However, the first scientific publication regarding nuclear fission was signed only by Lise's male colleagues. In 1944, Otto Hahn was awarded the Nobel Prize for his contributions. Lise, after 49 nominations for the prize, was never accredited nor awarded for her work in nuclear fission. But sometimes, history rights its wrongs, and Lise became well-known and honored in the scientific community. In 1997, atomic element number 109 was named Methnerium in Lise's memory. Scientists have even named craters on the Moon, on Venus, and asteroids after her. 2016 saw the founding of the Lise Methner Society for the promotion of gender equality in science. So scientists have become aware of her talents, but her character, to me, is what sticks out. To think, despite her career frustrations, Lise chose not to participate in the Manhattan Project for research and development of the atomic bomb when called upon. And what about Caroline Haslett, British electrical engineer and early champion of women's rights, who played a very special role in opening up the world of engineering to females? She advocated for the use of electrical power and appliances at home to save time and energy, with the idea of allowing wives to pursue ambitions outside the home. Caroline was the daughter of a railway signaler, interested early on in machinery and tools. While her father worked away on the lines, her mother spent the day cleaning, washing, and cooking with no machines to help. A mother's hard work is something that stuck with Caroline. After learning office skills in college, Caroline joined an engineering firm that produced steam engine boilers, which held high demand during the Great War. She progressed within the company, but left in 1919 to become first secretary of the Women's Engineering Society, also known as WES. There, she edited a magazine titled The Woman Engineer and recommended newly invented appliances that could be used in domestic households. The appliances included the vacuum cleaner and Frédéric's favorite, the washing machine. In 1934, Caroline co-founded Electrical Association for Women and became its first director. She gave lectures, published books and magazines, and helped inform women about electricity, safety and installation. With her career on the apps, Caroline promoted technophoria and fought to use technology to liberate women while contributing to the domestic science movement. And in 1935, she pioneered the all-electric house in Bristol. Sitting on electrical engineering committees, she was often the sole woman delegate. And later, she became the vice president of international federations, which made her the first woman to chair a government working party in 1945. No wonder she was dubbed Dame Commander of the Order of the British Empire for her services to the Ministry of Labour and Board of Trade. So, those are our three leaders of electricity. How about a quick summary? Marie Curie was the first woman to win the Nobel Prize. She was the only person to win two Nobel Prizes in separate scientific fields, in physics and chemistry. Edith Clark was a renowned electrical engineer and mathematician, known for creating the Clark calculator and for her work in transmission systems. Lise Methner was an undercredited physicist who helped to expand our knowledge of nuclear energy processes, all the while refusing to betray her convictions. Caroline Haslett was an engineer known for her influence on using electricity in the domestic household, simplifying tedious tasks. You see, Frédéric?
There are many female scientists who helped shape our modern world.
Indeed, but I must say, Dame Caroline is my favorite for the...
We know, the washing machine.
Yes.
Do you have any woman in electricity that put a spark in your mind? How they have influenced history, science, or shaped your daily life? Leave a comment below, and thanks for having me here on What's What. It was a pleasure.
That it was, Sylvie. Thanks for stopping by. We would love to have you back anytime. But for now, it's adios from the Nexans team. Tuning out!